Hi friends, welcome to quickserve.com and now we are back again to discuss the second test match which is happening between England versus Pakistan. So in the first test match, as we know, the England fought very hard in the second innings and they chased 273 runs to take a lead in the series. But now Pakistan and the England, they are now in their second test match and Pakistan once again is batting first. So 2 days plays has already happened and Pakistan is 223 runs for the loss of 9 wickets. So it's basically kind of the same story that happened with Pakistan in the first innings of the first test match. And they are likely, most likely will add 20-30 runs tomorrow and 250 runs like they did in the first match. So the match has been rain affected and a lot of bad light have stopped the play, otherwise we would have moved forward in the test match, which is like only one innings has happened in the two test matches and not a lot of overs have been bowled. It's just 86 overs, so only one day of play has been played and the one day of play is affected by the rain and the bad light. So what we have in the contributions, as we talk about who are the players who fought for Pakistan, because the wicket is seeming the bowlers are getting swing. Chris Wokes, if he bowls the ball to like at a half volley length, or he just bowls near to the stumps, he's getting a swing. So you remember Chris Wokes got out Virat Kohli also in one delivery he bowled, which is kind of was very full on the off stump. So Virat Kohli hit I think two or three fours consecutively, then Chris Wokes put one very full delivery and Virat Kohli was caught behind. So he gets the swing when he bowls the full deliveries and the wickets is helping him with his action. And if we talk about coming back to the batsmen who have impressed, we have one batsman who has impressed everyone is Mohammad Rizwan. So Pakistan were already 180 runs for the eight wickets and he has been fighting single-handedly from there. So he has made 60 runs and he is not done yet. He will try to add more runs as whatever he can with the last batsman with Nasheem Shah on the other end. So there was one change Pakistan has made from the last playing 11 what they played in the first test match. So Shadab Khan, as he was very unimpressive, he was not given that much bowling, and Yasir Shah was completely dominating him from the other end, and the captain also was not seeing anything coming out of him. So he has been replaced and the replacement came return for the Fawad Alam. So Fawad Alam, the very unorthodox batsman, if like you have seen Fawad Alam batting stance, it's very different to of the normal cricketing batsman. It's like I think it's more weird than Shivnarine Chandrapal and any other batsman. But all that weirdness or all that uniqueness didn't help him this time, as he didn't bother the scorecard and he was out for zero in the first innings. So that's not a very good return for him after he is already 34, and if he has to have any chances of playing cricket for the Pakistan from here, he has to make runs in the second innings. So he was looking in pressure. A lot of talk is happening on the Fawad Alam. I watched the Shoaib Akhtar's video in which he did a video on Fawad Alam, basically talking to him, and he has been doing a lot of training and he has been putting runs in the domestic circuit, but all that counts to none if you don't perform when you get chance in the international cricket. So he has to show the performances in the second innings, otherwise it's the career done for him. So Rizwan was helped by Babar Azam. Babar Azam is playing like better than other batsmen, but he is also not looking a class apart. He is making those 40s, 45s, but he is not going too much far with his innings. He just manages like 40, 45 runs and then he gets out. That's not what make you a great batsman. If you want to be tagged as a great batsman, then you will have to score at least a century in the difficult conditions. So he will also have to reassess his game and see where he is making the mistakes. It's basically the drives. So drives look full-fledged drives look very appealing to the eyes, very appealing to the fans, because it looks so good on the TV, and the people are very much influenced by how it looks in the TV. They start judging the player as a very good cricketing batsman if he plays a very good drive. But if you talk about drive, it comes with a risk also. So drive is the most risky shot in the test cricket, because it opens up the slip corner, the wicket keeper. So the bowler's intention is always like you make the batsman play drive, and if he plays the full-fledged drive, you have the every chance in the world to take his wicket. So like Virat Kohli used to do, he doesn't play full-fledged drive. He used to use his wrist and he used to play check drives all the time. If you see the Virat Kohli's drives, it's never the full-flowing cover drives. It's always the check drives. So check drives eliminates that the instances of getting nicked to the wicketkeeper or to the slip cordon. So basically, you have to have some resistance playing, going for that juicy half volley, playing full-fledged drive. Otherwise, you will be in trouble. So he has to up his game, Babar Azam. And there were some contribution from Azhar Ali, but mostly the runs were coming from the slip cordon, and it was not looking very convincing of him. But he played with a good strike rate. He made 60 runs. So, but the innings was very scratchy and means a lot of runs coming from the slip cordon. So Rizwan has been the batsman for the Pakistan. So Rizwan also, when he came first, he was not that a good batsman. But ever since he made a comeback, he has hit century in the One Day International also, and he has upped his game. So he played some rash shots when Pakistan were 8 down. So in order to increase the run rate, he was playing some rash shots. Luckily, he didn't get out. But otherwise, he has done well for the Pakistan. So England will want to wrap it up as soon as possible in the one or two overs, and will not like to repeat the mistakes they have done in the first match. They will like to score a good reply to this Pakistan first innings total, and Pakistan will have to bowl very great, and also the crucial will be the second innings for the Pakistan. So that's what have been happened. The test match so far, 223 runs at the loss of 9 wickets, 2 days are done. And now on the day 3rd, Mohammad Rizwan will like to add some more vital runs to the Pakistan scoreboard. So that's all for now. We will connect you again on what will happen in the match on the third day. Till then, stay healthy, stay safe.